Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Life Science with Nivedita. So this is KC 2021 Life Sciences answer keys. Through this video, we are finding the answer of each question. With that, we are discussing the concept as well. So without any further delay, let's get started. So the first question is, in ABC model of flower development in Arabidopsis thaliana, B plus C determines the development of what? Okay, so this question is based on the ABC flower modeling. Okay, so here they will asking what B plus C represent. So here the flowers oils are there, right? So based on that, questions will be asked. So in the flower, four oils are there, right? This is sepal, after sepal, petal. So after petal, stamen. So after the stamen, carpels middle, right? So here they will asking B plus C. So let us see where B plus C is present. So A represent sepal. Okay, this is first oral. First oral A represents sepal, and in the second oral A plus B. So this A plus B will represent petal. Okay, the second oral is there, no, here that one, and also the third oral will represent B plus C. So this is stamen. Okay, B plus C will represent stamens, and at last the fourth oral C alone will represent carpel. Okay, so in this question they have asking B plus C. So B plus C represent what? That is stamen. So answer for the answer for first question is option D, stamen is the correct answer. Okay, so now move on to the next question. The second question is, which of the following assumptions is necessary for Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium law to hold? Okay, so here they were asking about the Hardy-Weinberg law. So in this law, there are five assumptions are coming. Okay, so the number one assumption is no mutation. Number two assumption is random mating. And also number three assumption is no gene flow. And number four assumption is infinite population size. And also number five, fifth assumption is no selection. Okay, so based on this criteria, the answer for the second question is option D, random mating. Okay, option D, random mating is the correct answer for second question. Okay, so let us move on to the next question. What is the genetic relatedness between grandparent and grandchildren? Okay, so this is based on the genetic relatedness question. Okay, so here they will asking between the grandparent and also grandchildren. So when come to the genetic relatedness, the identical twins will obtain one. Okay, based on the genetic relatedness, identical twins relatedness is one, and also from parent to child, that is half. Half is nothing but what? 0.5, right? So when come to the grandparent to grandchildren, the genetic relatedness is 1/4. This is nothing but what? 0.25. okay, so according to this, which is the answer? Option B is the correct answer for third question. Okay, so let us move on to the next question, that is fourth one. So okay, which of the following expresses CD3 surface antigen? Okay, they're asking CD3 surface antigen is where is expressed. Okay, so this will express in the T cells. Okay, so answer for the fourth question is T cells. Okay, so now move on to the next question. Fifth one is what? Unlamellate thylakoid occur in where? Okay, so this unlamellate thylakoids is present in the cyanobacteria. Okay, cyanobacteria is nothing but what? Blue green algae, right? So example for blue green algae, Nostoc. Okay, so according to this, which is the answer? So for the fifth question, answer is option B, Nostoc. Okay, so now move on to the next question. Which of the following statement is correct? Option A, meiosis 1 occurs in primary spermatocyte. Option B, meiosis 1 occur in secondary spermatocyte. Option C, meiosis 1 occur in spermatids. And option D, meiosis 2 occurs in spermatids. So this question is based on spermatogenesis. Okay, the sperm production takes place, right? So based on that concept, they will ask in the question. Okay, so here this spermatogenesis will include five stages. Okay, the first stage is spermatogonia. Okay, so after this, primary spermatocyte will be produced. So after this, secondary spermatocyte. So after this, spermatid. Okay, after this spermatid, and at last it is produced spermatozoa. Okay, so in between here, mitosis will takes place, and here meiosis one, and here meiosis two, and here differentiation takes place. Okay, so in the question they are asking which is the correct option. Okay, so here meiosis one will takes place where? In the primary spermatocyte. Okay, not in the secondary, and also not in the spermatid, not in the spermatozoa. So it is takes place in the primary spermatocyte. So according to this, which is the answer? Which is the answer for the sixth question? That is option A. That is meiosis one occurs in primary spermatocyte. Okay, for the sixth question, option A is the answer. So now move on to the next question. Which of the following statements is true about ionophores? Okay, so the first of all, ionophores is nothing but ion carriers. Okay, you know, ionophores is nothing but what? Ion carriers. So here they are asking which is true. So let us move on to the options. Option A, ionophores increase permeability of selected ions. Option 2, valinomycin is an ionophore for potassium ions. Option 3, valinomycin is made up of L amino acids. Option 4, valinomycin has 10 to the power 4 fold of greater binding affinity for potassium than sodium. Okay, so first of all, this valinomycin is an antibiotic. Okay, this valinomycin is what? It is antibiotic. Okay, so this ionophores is an ion carrier which will transport of ions across biological membrane. So here passive transport of ions will be takes place. Okay, so the first option is correct because it is increased permeability of the selected ions. Then come to the second option, this valinomycin is antibiotic and it is for potassium ions. This is also correct option. And in third option, valinomycin is made up of L amino acid. Yes, it is made up of L valine. Valine is amino acid, right? So that's why this is also correct. When come to the fourth option, here they have mentioned valinomycin has 10 to the power of 4 fold, but here it is 10 to the power of 6 fold of greater binding affinity. Okay, so that's why, which is the answer according to this, the A, that is first option is the correct, that is only first option, second option and third option is correct, fourth option is wrong. Okay, so according to this, for the seventh question, A is the correct answer. Okay, so now let us move on to the next question. Embryo sac in plants represent what? Okay, so here the embryo sac in plants represent female gametophyte. Okay, so according to this, the question, eighth question answer is option D, female gametophyte. Okay, now move on to the next question. Which of the following is not used for ex situ plant conservation? So here ex situ plant conservation means which will give artificial environment. Okay, so it is somehow similar like natural habitat itself, but give artificially environment. So option A, seed bag. Option B, shifting cultivation. Option C, field gene banks. Option D, botanical gardens. Here they will ask which is not. Okay, so seed bank is also ex situ, and also field gene banks is also ex situ, botanical gardens is also ex situ, but this shifting cultivation is not ex situ plant conservation. Okay, so option B is the correct answer for ninth question. Okay, so now move on to the next one. In humans, height shows wide variation is an example of what? Okay, option A, multiple alleles. Option B, pleiotropic inheritance. Option C, polygenic inheritance. And option D, pseudocele. So here the answer is polygenic inheritance, means many genes will be involved in this height character. Okay, so option C is the correct answer for 10th question. So now move on to the next one. Okay, so the 11th question is, Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium is known to be affected by gene flow, genetic drift, mutation, genetic recombination, and what? The answer for this 11th question is option D, natural selection. So along with this gene flow, genetic drift, mutation, genetic recombination, natural selection is also one, is also affected by Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. Okay, so answer for the 11th question is option D. So now move on to the next question, that is 12th one. Here they will ask, from which part of the coconut the coir is obtained? Okay, in which part of the coconut coir is obtained? They have asked. Here it is present in the mesocarp. Okay, so mesocarp is present between the hard end shell is there, right? In the coconut, hard internal shell is right? So between that internal shell and also outer coat is present in the coconut, right? So between these two, this mesocarp is present there, this coir is obtained. Okay, so which is answer for the 12th question? Option B is the answer. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is polar bodies. So what is polar bodies? Here option A have no known function, option B protect the egg, option C protect the sperm, option D ensure fertilization. So here polar bodies is formed to enclose the excess DNA, where excess DNA is present, to enclose that thing this polar bodies will form. Okay, when this is formed? During the oocyte formation. Okay, so that's why the function of this polar bodies is to protect the egg. Okay, so answer for this 13th question is option B, to protect the egg. Okay, so now move on to the next question, 14th one. What is F2 dihybrid ratio in a recessive epistatic interaction of genes? So first of all, recessive epistasis means when recessive allele of one gene, for example, this is recessive allele, this gene will mask the effect of the second gene. Okay, this gene will masking means what? Hiding. Okay, so this will mask the effect of other gene, that is in the second gene. Okay, so this is first gene, this is second gene, but this is second gene. Okay, so this gene will mask the expression of this second gene. This is known as recessive epistatic interaction. Okay, so which is the answer for the 14th one? That when come to the ratio of the recessive epistatic interaction is 9:3:4. Okay, so answer for this 14th question is option B. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is 15th one. Okay, so selenocysteine is coded by option A, UAA, option B, UAG, option C, UGA, option D, AUG. So answer for this question is option C, UGA. Okay, selenocysteine is coded by UGA codon. Okay. So now move on to the 16th question. Here they will asking, in an enzyme reaction, if the enzyme concentration is increased from 1 mg to 2 mg, which one of the statements is correct? Okay, option A, Km and Vmax will remain constant. Option B, Km will change while Vmax will remain constant. Option C, Km will remain constant but Vmax will increase. Option D, Km and Vmax both will increase. So first of all, Vmax is nothing but what? It is a maximum reaction rate. Okay, so Vmax is nothing but it shows a maximum reaction. Okay, so Km is nothing but what? Km is a half of the Vmax. Okay, so half of the Vmax is nothing but Kmax. So here what happened? Vmax is depend on enzyme concentration. This will depends on enzyme concentration, but here this Km is not depend on enzyme concentration. Means if enzyme concentration increased, okay, if enzyme concentration increase, Vmax will get doubled. Okay, so but Km is not getting doubled, Km is stay as constant. Okay, so that's why answer for this question is option C, Km will remain constant, but here Vmax will increase. So Vmax will increase but Km is remain constant. So answer for the 16th question is option C. So now move on to the next question. Esterification of cholesterol in plasma is catalyzed by what? Okay, so answer for this question is option A, lecithin equals cholesterol acyl transferase. So this cholesterol acyl transferase is an enzyme which is responsible for esterification. Esterification means what? The ester bonds will form, right, in the lipid. So that is known as esterification. So answer for the 17th question is option A. Okay, so now move on to the next question. A child of O blood group has B group father. The genotype of the father will be what? Okay, this is blood grouping question. Here they will ask what? The blood group of child is O, O group. Okay, and blood group of father is B. Right? They have given in the question. Child blood group is O and father blood group is B. Okay, so they have asking the genotype of the father will be what? Okay, so when come to the father, B blood group, right? So the genotype should be IB and IO. When come to the child, O blood group, right? So that's why IO and IO. Okay, so here what happened? This child blood group is there, no? This is recessive. O is recessive than B, right? So that's why. So answer for this question is option D. IB and IO, that is father blood group, the genotype of the father blood group is IB and IO. So answer for the 18th question is option D. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is 19th one. Okay, so CIPCO movement was initiated for the protection of what? So usually this movement is takes place for about cutting of trees, right? So cutting of trees means nothing but what? That is related to forest. Okay, so question 19 answer is option B. Okay, so now move on to the next one. Cytotoxic T cells can be recognized by which of the following cell surface marker? Here they are asking cytotoxic T cells, that is nothing but TC cells, right? So TC cells is present where? In the MHC class 1 molecule, and here CD8 is present. If they will asking the T helper cell, that is present in the MHC class 2, and here that is CD4. Okay, here they will asking cytotoxic T cell, that is nothing but TC cells. So that's why which is the cell surface marker? That is CD8. Okay, which is the answer? Option C, CD8 is the correct answer for 20 question. Okay, so now move on to the next question. Acid rain is produced by option A, excess nitrogen. Excess nitrogen oxide and sulfur dioxide from burning fossil fuels. Option B, excess production of ammonia by industries and power plants. Option C, excess release of carbon monoxide by incomplete combustion of fossil fuels. Option D, excess release of carbon dioxide by combustion and animal respiration. So here for the acid rain, these two gases is responsible, that is nitrogen oxide and also sulfur dioxide. So according to this, option A is the correct answer for 21 question. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So in the 22 question, they have asking about Drosophila displays dash method of embryonic development. Okay, so the 22nd question, they have asking about the Drosophila embryonic development. Okay, so answer for this question is holometabolus. Okay, so here there is three phases present. Holometabolus means in the post embryonic stage, that is three stages are present. That is larva is converted into pupa. So this pupa is converted into adult. Okay, so this is the embryonic development of Drosophila. The method is holometabolus. So option C is the correct answer for 22nd question. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So in the 23 question, they have asking about in C4 plants, Kelvin cycle occur where? Option A occurs in mesophyll cells. Option B occurs in stroma of chloroplast. Option C occurs in gran of chloroplast. Option D do not occur as carbon dioxide is fixed mainly by the postprandial pyruvate and no carbon dioxide is left for Kelvin cycle. So usually the C4 cycle is physically separate carbon fixation from Kelvin cycle. Okay, that is here they will separately fix the carbon. Okay, for the fixing of carbon, separately they will fix, that is which enzyme? Phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase. Okay, so this enzyme is responsible for the fixation of carbon. So that's why answer for this 23rd question is option D. In C4 plants, it does not occur as carbon dioxide is fixed mainly by PEP and no carbon dioxide is left for Kelvin cycle. Okay, so and also example for C4 plants are sugarcane, sorghum, and also corn. Okay, so this is about 23rd question. So now move on to the next question. which of the hormone relates to biological clock? Okay, so biological clock means light and dark cycle. Okay, so light and dark cycle is present right in our daily life. So it is responsible for body's daily cycle. Woke up and sleep cycle also we can say this thing. Okay, so here the answer for this question is option C, melatonin. Okay, so answer for the 24 question is what? Option C, melatonin. So now move on to the next question. So 25th question is about stabilization of the unique coiled structure of an alpha helix in a protein is primarily attributed to what? Okay, so answer for this question is hydrogen bonding. In the structure of alpha helix, the stabilized bonding is hydrogen bonding between peptide backbones. Okay, answer for the 25th question is option A. So now move on to the next question. So in 26th question, they have asking about protein destined to be secreted move through the secretory pathway in which of the following order. So here they will asking the order of the protein secretion. So here answer for this question is option B. First it is enter into the rough endoplasmic reticulum, then Golgi transport vesicle, after that Golgi cisternae, then it is enter the secretory vesicle, at last it will reach cell surface. Okay, so answer for the 26th question is option B. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So 26 easy, right? This we will discuss in the lecture series video as well. So here the answer for the 27, that is the unit, what they will asking, the unit of distance in linkage map is what? Option C, centimorgan is the unit of distance in linkage map. Okay, so the next question is the gene that is not involved in the body patterning in Drosophila. So answer for this question is SXL gene. In the body patterning, gap gene also involved, segment polarity gene also involved, pair rule gene also involved, but this SXL gene is not involved. This is nothing but sex lethal gene. Okay, sex is nothing but what? It is nothing but sex lethal gene. This is not involved in the patterning of Drosophila. Okay, so according to this, which is the answer? So option C is the answer for 28th question. So now move on to the next question, that is 29th. Okay, so hemophilia is a sex-linked recessive triad in humans. If a father and a son are both hemophilic, but the mother is normal, her genotype must be what? So here they will asking, father and son is affected, but mother is normal. So what is the genotype of mother should be? So let us see what is that. So in the option they have given X small h. So this represents mother is hemophilia. In the options, okay, in the option, the first option they will given, that is mother is hemophilia, and the second option they will given, the mother is carrier, and the third option they will given, mother is normal. This alphabet is represent what I'm writing. Okay, so mother is normal. So in the last option, this is XY. So here they will asking the mother genotype, right? So mother means which chromosome? That is XX chromosome. So here they will mention Y chromosome. This option is not at all correct. Okay, so here they will ask father is also affected, right? So father genotype should be, once again, so father genotype should be like this, because X chromosome for the son is donated from mother, right? So the son genotype should be like this, right? So here Y is normal, X is affected. So that's why father is also affected. And here the normal Y is received from the father. But here what happened? Mother having carrier. Okay, she is having two X genes, right? So one X chromosome will be donated to the son. So here she will donate the carrier gene. That's why the son is affected. Okay, so according to this, which is the answer? The mother is a carrier, right? So that's why option B is the correct answer for this 29th question. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So that is 30 question. So here fluorescence recovery after photo bleaching, that is FRAP. It is a technique. Okay, so it is a powerful technique for calculating what? ऑप्शन ए द डिफ्यूजन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ मेम्ब्रेन लिपिड्स एंड प्रोटीन्स, ऑप्शन बी द रेट ऑफ सिंथेसिस ऑफ मेम्ब्रेन प्रोटीन्स, ऑप्शन सी द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ए लिपिड एंड ए मेम्ब्रेन प्रोटीन, ऑप्शन डी द एक्सटेंट ऑफ सिग्नल ट्रांसडक्शन इन मेम्ब्रेन अपॉन लिगैंड रिसेप्टर इंटरैक्शंस. ओके सो हियर दिस फ्रैप टेक्निक इज देयर राइट. सो दिस इज हेल्पफुल फॉर द डिटरमाइनिंग द काइनेटिक्स ऑफ डिफ्यूजन थ्रू टिश्यू एंड सेल्स. ओके सो विच इज द आंसर, ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर 30 question, that is the diffusion coefficient of membrane lipids and proteins will be calculating from this FRAP technique. Okay, so now move on to the next question. At which cell cycle checkpoint is the cell cycle halted if the cell's DNA is damaged? Halted means what? Stop. Okay, so they will ask in where the checkpoint the cell cycle will be halted if DNA is damaged. So when come to the cell cycle, S phase, after this G2 phase. So after G2, so initially G1 phase, right? So after G1, S phase, after S, G2, after G2, that is M phase. Okay, again, this cycle will be repeated. So here, where in the which checkpoint in this cycle, where the cell cycle will be halted, no? That is between the G2 and M here. Okay, here the cell cycle will be halted if there is any cell DNA takes place. Okay, so which is the answer? That is option C is the answer. That is between G2 and M, right? So that's why option C, G2 and M is the correct answer for 31st question. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is 32-1. So, which of the following occurs in meiosis but not in mitosis? Okay. Option A, attachment of spindle fibers to the kinetic core. Option B, pairing of homologous chromosomes at the metaphase place. Option C, replication of DNA prior to the start of cell cycle. Option D, separation of sister chromatids at anaphase. Okay. So, here for 32 question, option B is the right answer. Okay, so this pairing of homologous chromosomes at the metaphase plate is not occur in meiosis but not occur in mitosis. Okay, so for the 32 question, option B is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question, that is 33. Okay, so which of the following technique could be used to demonstrate protein binding to specific DNA sequences? Okay, so our answer for this question is ELISA, that is electrophoretic mobility shift assay. So here the DNA electrophoretic mobility shift assay means it is used to study proteins binding. Okay, it is used to study protein binding to known DNA oligosaccharides probes. Okay, protein binding with the known DNA oligosaccharide probes we will study in the ELISA technique. Okay, so answer for the 33rd question is option D. Okay, so now move on to the next question. Which eukaryotic cellular organelles are believed to have evolved from symbiotic bacteria? Okay, option A, endoplasmic reticulum and the Golgi apparatus. Option B, lysosomes. Option C, mitochondria and chloroplast. Option D, peroxisomes. Okay, so here the answer for this question is option C, mitochondria and chloroplast during the endobiosis. Okay, in the endosymbiosis process, they will be find out. So here, by this endosymbiosis process, they will thought to have evolved from bacteria and this mitochondria and chloroplast. By this endosymbiosis process, they will thought to have evolved from bacteria living in large cell. Okay, so here answer for the 34th question is option C, mitochondria and chloroplast. So now move on to the next question. That is 35th question. Which cellular organelles are involved in the initiation of the intrinsic pathway of apoptosis? So answer for this question is mitochondria. Mitochondria is involved in the initiation of the intrinsic pathway of apoptosis. Okay, so now move on to the next question. People who have an extra X chromosome may have gotten it through which function? Okay, so answer for this question is option B, non-disjunction. So extra X chromosome means what? XXY. So what is the condition called as? Klinefelter syndrome, right? So if any extra X chromosome is present, that syndrome is called as Klinefelter syndrome. So here what happened? In most cases, either the mother's egg cell or father's sperm cell divides incorrectly, which is results to the one extra X chromosome. Okay, so answer for the 36th question is option B, non-disjunction. So now move on to the next question. Okay, so embryonic stem cells are obtained from the inner mass of the dash as a precursor. Okay, answer for this question is blastocyst. Option D, blastocyst is the answer. So here it is blastocyst is a pluripotent stem cells which is derived from inner mast cells of blastocyst. Okay, that is in the pre-implantation embryo stage is there now. So there this blastocyst will be act like a precursor. Okay, so then move on to the next question, that is 38th question. So what is the natural function of type 2 restriction enzymes? Okay, the natural function of type 2 restriction enzyme is it will protect the bacteria by cleavaging their own DNA. Okay, so answer for 38th question is option B. So now move on to the next one. So HIV infected T cell carries the antigen on their surface, that is CD4. Very easy. Option C is the answer for 39 question. So here it is a presence on surface of helper T cell, that is TH cells. Okay, so these cells will be migrate and reside in the mucous membrane of our body, right? Because HIV will produce through sexual contact, right? That is from the semen. So in that mucous membrane, this CD4 cell surface antigen will be transferred. Okay, so now move on to the next question, 41. Okay, so which of the following technique is considered as environmentally friendly to clean up organic pollution and toxic waste? Option A, gamma irradiation. Option B, chlorination. Option C, bioremediation. Option D, biomagnification. So answer for this question is option C, bioremediation. Okay, this process is called as, that is, this is a technique which is considered as environmental friendly because it will clean up the pollution and also toxic waste. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is 41. Okay, so here they will ask about genes that evolved by duplication but may not have identical functions are called what? Okay, so answer for this question is paralogous. Okay, the genes which have evolved by duplication but may not have identical functions are called as paralogous. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So 42 is Warburg effect is characterized by what? So Warburg effect is nothing but increased glycolysis. Glycolysis will be increased by this Warburg effect. So here it is found in the cancer cells. Okay, it is found where? In the cancer cells, because when glycolysis will be increased, what happened? Glucose uptake is also increased and also lactate is also increased, right? So that's why the Warburg effect is characterized by increased glycolysis. Okay, so answer for the 42 question is option A. So now move on to the next question. So the next question is secondary metabolites are produced in which of the following stages? Option A, lag phase. Option B, log phase. Option C, stationary phase. And option D, death phase. Okay, so secondary metabolites are produced in the stationary phase. Okay, so answer for the 43rd question is option C. Okay, so now move on to the next question. It's 44, right? So a haploid sperm from one species. A haploid sperm from one species and a haploid egg from another species may form a diploid interspecies hybrid. So meiosis in these plants generally fails but can lead to rare duplicated gametes called what? Okay, so here haploid sperm and haploid egg will produce diploid interspecies hybrid. Okay, so this condition we called as a allopolyploid. Okay, so answer for the 44th question is option D, allopolyploid. Okay, so now move on to the next question, 45th, right? So here Epistaxis is an example for what? Option A, incomplete dominant inheritance. Option B, incomplete recessive inheritance. Option C, deviation of Mendelian inheritance. Option D, extra chromosomal inheritance. Okay, so first of all, epistaxis is a, it is one gene completely masks the another gene character, right? So that's why here option A is the correct answer. So it is a incomplete dominant inheritance is an example for epistaxis. Okay, so now move to the next question. So a head and a tail region of the lipid will represent what? So right, so phospholipid structure, we know, right? So this is head, these two are tail. So this head will represent what? This will represent hydrophilic head and also hydrophobic. These two tails are hydrophobic. Hydrophilic means what? Water loving. Hydrophobic means what? Water hating. Okay, so according to this, which is the answer? Option A is the correct answer. That is, head is the hydrophilic and tail is the hydrophobic. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So 46th question is, according to Neo-Darwinism, unit of evolution refers to what? Okay, so here unit of evolution refers to option B, population. Okay, answer for the 47th question is option B, population. So now move on to the next question, that is 48. So here extreme phenotypes are favored over other phenotypes is called option A, disruptive selection, option B, stabilizing selection, option C, frequency dependent selection, option D, directional selection. So here the answer is directional selection. Okay, so this is a mode of natural selection and this directional selection is also called as positive selection. Okay, so answer for the 48th question is option D, directional selection. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is 49th, right? So here the population stabilizes on a particular non-extreme triad value is called what? Okay, so this is nothing but stabilizing selection. Okay, the population stabilizes on a particular non-extreme triad value, that is called as stabilizing selection. So this is also a type of natural selection. Okay, option C is the correct answer for 49th question. So now move on to the next question of 50 question. So here, which of the following is a not a parasite of humans? Okay, so option A, Plasmodium vivax, it is also parasite. Option B, Trypanosoma brucelli, this is also parasite. Option C, Fasciola hepatica, yes, this is also. Option D, Lumbericus terrestris, no, this is not a human parasite. Okay, so this Lumbericus terrestris means common earthworm. Okay, this common earthworm is not a parasite of human, right? So that's why option D is correct answer. Means in the question they will asking not. So that's why this is not a human parasite. So when come to the rest of the options, Plasmodium vivax will produce malaria disease and Trypanosoma brucelli will cause sleeping sickness and also this Fasciola hepatica will cause liver flank. Okay, that is liver disease. Okay, so now move on to the next question. It's 51. Okay, so specimen which have been referred by the author as similar to type selection. So here type selection is nothing but one specimen. Okay, so option B, holotype is the correct answer for 51 question. Okay, so now move to the next question, that is 52. So here in vertebrates, the combination of PAX6, SOX2, SOX3, LMAF transcription factors in the ectoderm of the optic vesicles ensures the production of eye, or that is lens. Okay, so these genes are responsible for the production of, that is lens. Okay, so option B, lens is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question, that is 53rd. Okay, so here they will ask which of the following is not a biodiversity hotspot of India. Western Ghat is also a biodiversity hotspot, Himalaya also, Andaman and Nicobar Islands also, but this Chambal range is there, no, this is not a biodiversity hotspot of India. Okay, option D is the correct answer for 53 question. So now move on to the next question, 54. So what is the penetrance of polydactyly if 64 people have normal fingers and 16 have abnormal number of fingers? Okay, so here they will asking what the penetrance of the polydactyly. Okay, so here 64 is what? 64 is normal and 16 is having polyp, that is abnormal, that is polydactyl finger, right? So here when come to the ratio, 16 is the abnormal and 64 is the normal, right? So here when come to the 1:4 ratio, that is nothing but what? 0.2. Okay, option A is the answer for 54 question. So now move on to the next question, that is 55. Okay, so causal agent of bacterial blight of the paddy is caused by what? So answer for this question is option D, that is Xanthomonas oryzae. Okay, so next question is, which one of the following is maternally contributed RNA in the early development of Drosophila embryo? So answer for the question is bicoid. So along with this bicoid, hunchback is also contributed. Okay. So option C is the correct answer for 56th question. So now move on to the next question, 57. Okay. So here an affected female marries a normal male, and if of their daughters and sons are affected, and the trait follows what? Okay. So here in the question, what they have given? Affected female. That is affected female will marry normal male. She marry with a normal male. Okay. So when come to the second generation, here what happened? What happened? Off of their daughters and off of their sons will be affected. Means, for example, for there in the second generation, male, female, male. Okay. So this represents female, this represents male. Okay. So this is daughter, this is son, this is daughter, this is son. Okay. So in the question, what they have mentioned? 50% of the son daughter is affected and 50% of the son is affected. That is nothing but what? 50% is healthy. Okay. So this is an example for autosomal dominant. Okay. That is option B is the answer for this question. Here they will express. Okay. Because it is not X-linked. I think it means what? If father is affected, daughter is also affected. It is not Y-linked also. So here it will express in the next generation as well. So that's why autosomal dominant mode is the answer for this question. Okay. That is option B is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question. Okay. So which one of the following enzymes cleaves RNA in a RNA DNA hybrid? Okay. So answer for this question is RNase H, that is option D. So it is a endonuclease enzyme. Okay. It has the ability to cleave RNA moiety of DNA RNA hybrid. Okay. So now move on to the next question, that is 59. So here Tata box and Pribno box are sites of what? Okay. So these two are sites of promoters. Option C is the correct answer for 59 question. So now move on to the next question, 60. Okay. So here, chemical responsible for Bhopal gas tragedy, right? So Bhopal gas tragedies happen. So for that tragedy, which gas are responsible? That is phosgene and also methyl isocyanate. So option A is the correct answer for 60 question. So now move on to the 61 question. So species found exclusively in Ecuador. This thing we have discussed in the question paper solving series, right? So which species? That is edge species. Option B is the correct answer for 61 question. Okay, so now move on to the next one. Okay, so which of the antibiotics affect premature translation termination? Option A, puromycin. Option B, streptomycin. Option C, chloramphenicol. Option D, erythromycin. So this puromycin is there now. This is an antibiotic which affects the premature translation termination. So this puromycin is derived from the streptomyces bacteria. Okay, streptomyces bacteria is there now. From that bacteria, this puromycin will be derived. So option A is the correct answer for 62nd question. So now move on to the next one. 63, that is vaccination is an example of what type of immunity? So vaccination means it is active immunity, but it is artificially active immunity because our body does not produce its own. If it is produce its own, means what? It is naturally acquired active immunity, but in the outside, it's through the vaccination our body will produce certain antibodies. That is example for artificially acquired active immunity. Okay, option A is the answer for 63rd question. So now move on to the next one. Okay. So here leaf accession takes place as option A, internodes, option B, that is base of the petiole, option C, nodes, option D, margin of the leaves. Okay, answer for this question is option B, base of the petiole. So this is a normal shedding of old leaves. Leaves accession is nothing but the old leaves is there, no, that will shedding down. Okay, so next question is a sewage treatment process in which a portion of decomposer bacteria present in the waste is recycled into the beginning of the process is called what? Okay, so this is called as activated sludge treatment. Okay, option C is the correct answer. So now move on to the next one, 66, right? So here in amino acid tRNA synthetase, while attaching tRNA to the amino acid, mechanism by which attaching wrong amino acid is avoided by what? Okay, so if any wrong thing is happening, that is corrected by what? Proofreading mechanism, right? So that's why option B is the correct answer for 66th question. So now move on to the next one. Okay, so here glucose transporter in the muscle responsive to insulin action is which transporters? Okay, so answer for this question is GLUT4. Okay, so major glucose transporter, that is protein expressed in a skeletal muscle. This is expressed where? In the skeletal muscle. Okay, option D is the correct answer. So next question, which is the endangered bird species of India? Okay, the endangered bird species of India is Great Indian Bustard. This is the endangered species in India. Okay, so now move on to the next question. 69. Okay. So inverted repeats is a feature found in where? So inverted repeats will be found in transposons. Okay, option D is the correct answer. So the 70 question, a histone linking with two nucleosomes. This is also we discussed in the question paper solving series, right? So the histone which is linking with the two nucleosomes, it is linker DNA, that is H1. Okay, so option A is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question, 71. Okay, so which of the following amino acids is most likely to disrupt an alpha helix? The answer, option C, proline is the amino acid which is responsible for disruption of alpha helix. Option C is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question. So the IUCN red data book contain list of what? So this IUCN red data book will contains 310 species. So in this they will include vulnerable and also endangered and also critically endangered. Okay, so all these list will be contains in this threatened, that is red data book. Option A is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question. Okay, so sometimes the first AUG codon is not the site of initiation of translation. The following is one method for the ribosome to get the correct start codon. Okay, so answer for this question is ribo switching. Okay, option B is the correct answer. So next one, the neural mechanism of regulation of respiration is primarily controlled by option B, medulla oblongata. The respiration is controlled by medulla oblongata. Okay, so next question, 75. Okay. In amphibians, vegetal cells opposite the region of sperm's entry will form dash part of the body. Okay, in the amphibians, the vegetal cells is present in here. Okay, so they will ask where in the opposite of the sperm entry, that part is known as what? Option A, dorsal is the correct answer. Okay, so now move on to the next question, this 76. So here they will ask which of the following statement is false regarding B cells. They will asking what? False option. So option A, B cells can undergo class switching and produce a different antibody. Option B, bone marrow stem cells migrate to the thymus and develop into B cells. Option C, B cells synthesize antibodies and put them on their cell surface. Option D, B cells can become memory cells. Okay, so here option B is also correct because B cells can undergo class switching. Yes, and come to the option B, bone marrow stem cells migrate into thymus and develop into B cells. No, it is not migrate into thymus. Okay, so when it is migrate into thymus, it will produce T-cells, not B-cells. Okay, so option C, B-cell synthesis antibodies, this is also correct, and B-cells can become memory cells, this is also correct. Okay, option, which one? Option B is the false statement, that's why option B is the correct answer for this question. Okay, so move on to the next question. So CDR4 is a carrier of what? Okay, CDR4 will contain ferric ion. Okay, this is iron chelating compound. This CDR4 is nothing but iron chelating compound. So option C, ferric ion, is the correct answer for this question. So now move on to the next question. Diagnostic tool that is used to measure and record the electrical activity of heart. Very easy. ECG, right? Electrocardiogram is the answer for 78th question. So now move on to the next one. Micro injection is used for which technique? That is transgenesis. That is transgenesis, nothing but what? Imparting the gene, new gene into the organism. Okay, so that's why option C is the correct answer for 79th question. So now move on to the next one. Okay, so in humans, Philadelphia chromosome is formed by reciprocal translocation between what chromosomes? Okay, so answer for the question is option D, 9 and 22. So this is identified in chronic myelogenous leukemia. Leukemia means what? Blood cancer, right? So this will found in the leukemia condition. Okay, so option D is the correct answer for 80 question. So now move on to the next one. So 81 question is what? Dash is a process which stops bleeding. Okay, which process is stops bleeding? Hemorrhage, right? Hemorrhage is nothing but what? Coagulation. Coagulation means what? The clotting of blood, right? So when, if any injury takes place, if any accident takes place in that time, coagulation has to be takes place, which is nothing but stoppage of bleeding. Okay, option A is the correct answer for 81 question. So now move on to the next question. 82nd, which enzyme is used to prevent relegation of restriction enzyme digested plasmid? Okay, so answer for the question is calf intestine phosphatase. Okay, so this calf intestine phosphatase enzyme will prevent the relegation. Okay, so that's why option D is the correct for 82 question. So now move on to the next question. Okay, so when a certain gene contains the following double-stranded sequences, this is one sequence. So if the top strand is sense strand, this is sense strand, okay? So and codes for a mRNA whose sequence begins with the AUG, okay? So which of the following would be the sequence of the corresponding segment of antisense? So they will asking the corresponding segments of antisense. So when come to the here, this is sense strand and this is antisense strand, right? So this is sense strand and this is antisense strand. So when it is converted into mRNA, this antisense strand is converted into mRNA, right? So now we got 5' AUG. AUG is the initiation codon, right? So AUG, UUU, AG, CG, CC, here 3'. Okay, so when this is act as a mRNA anticodon, it is converted into UAC, AAA, UCG, CGG. Okay, so it has, when it is corresponding to the antisense, it has to be in the this direction, right? So answer for this question is here 5', GGC, GC, UAAA, CAU. That is 5' to 3'. So that's why option C is the correct answer for this question. Okay, so now move on to the next one. Okay, so here, which of the following statements is true about miRNA? miRNA means what? MicroRNA. Okay, so option A, it is transcribed from DNA. Yes. Option B, RNase-3 is involved in its processing. Yes. Option 3, it is about 21 nucleotides long. No. Option 4, it is same as antisense. Okay, so here it is not 21, it is 22 nucleotides long. Okay, so option 3 is wrong. So that's why where 3 is not present, that is the correct answer. Okay, option 4 is also right. So that's why 1, 2 and 4, that is which one? Option C is the correct answer. Okay, option C is the correct for 84 question. So now move on to the next one. So one of the major causes of variation in genome size in eukaryotic cells is due to what? That is due to gene duplication. Okay, option A is the correct answer for 85th question. So next question, expression of virulence factor in bacteria is due to what? That is due to the quorum sensing. So here quorum sensing is nothing but what? Which is communication mechanism between bacteria. Okay, so example for this quorum sensing is biofilm formation. And the teeth and all biofilm is formed, right? That is that shows the virulence factor. Okay, so option A is the correct answer for 86th question. Okay, so now move on to the next question. So 86 is finished, right? So stop codon can become coding codon in where? Okay, so when come to the normal, that is your nuclear DNA, the stop codons are what? UAG, UAA, UG. Okay, so these three are stop codons in nuclear DNA. But when coming to the mitochondrial DNA, the stop codons are AUA, AUG, and also UGA. Okay, so here this UGA is a stop codon in nuclear DNA, but this UGA is UGA here, right? So this is coding in the mitochondrial DNA, not stop codon. Okay, so that's why option B is the correct answer. So for the 87 question, option B is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question. Okay, so phytoalexins are isoflavonoids produced by plants. Option A, storage compounds. Option B, for uptake of minerals. Option C, in response to pathogen attack. Option D, as insect repellent. Okay, so option C is the answer, that is in response to pathogen attack, this phytoalexins and isoflavonoids are produced. Okay, option C is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question. Which of the following proteins first bind to TATA box during transcription? Okay, so here transcription factor 2D will first come and bind to the TATA box. Yeah, TATA box is there in the during the transcription. So in this TATA box, transcription factor 2D will first come and bind. Okay, so option B is the correct answer for 89 question. So now move to the next question. Okay. So, viruses of which family are used as biological control agents against insects? Okay, so here, Baculoviridae family viruses are used as a biological control agent, that is, as act as a pesticides. To control the insects, they will use this virus family as a pesticides. Okay, option C is the correct answer for 90 question. So, now move on to the next question. So, the period of cardiac cycle during which the heart muscle relaxes. Okay, so relaxes with refills blood is called what? So relax is nothing but what here? Diastole. Okay, so contraction means systole. Here they will asking relaxation. That's why option D is the correct answer for 91 question. So now move on to the next question. Okay, so parthenocarpy can be induced by what? Option A, treating the stigma by lanoline. Option B, abscisic acid and ethylene treatment. Option C, exposure to infrared rays. Option D, auxin and gibberellin treatment. Here they will give the wrong answer. This is not auxin. This is auxin. Okay, so for the 92nd question, option D, auxin and gibberellic acid is the correct answer. Okay, so now move on to the next question. That is 93rd. Okay, so here, genes P and Q are necessary for normal hearing. A deaf man marries a deaf woman and all their children had normal hearing. The genotypes of the parents, what? Okay, so here what happened? P and Q are the normal hearing genes. Okay, so here they will mention what? Deaf man marries a deaf woman. Both parents are deaf, but the children are normal. So how come it's possible? Because in the parent gene, they will have carrier, that is dominant gene will be transferred. One second. Yes. Right. So here, see, the option C is the correct answer for this question. Means here, both dominant genes has to be present, right? So here, see, this is also, this is dominant here. This is also dominant here because P and Q is responsible for hearing, right? So that's why deliver one dominant gene of the from the parent will responsible for normal hearing in the children. So that's why option C is the correct answer for 93rd question. So now move on to the next question. Okay. So Hamilton rule is related to what? So when come to the formula of Hamilton rule, that is RB is greater than C. Okay. So R will represent relatedness. Okay. R will represent what? Relatedness. So here it is proportion of shared genes. This will shows, no, this R will shows shared genes proportion, and this B will represent benefit. Benefit of the recipient will show in the B, and C will represent cost of the altruist, means what behavioral changes will be takes place, right? So that will represent by C. So according to this, the answer for this 94th question is option D, that is cost versus benefit of a behavioral triad. Okay. So the next question is the X-ray diffraction studies conducted by Dash were the key to discover of a structure of DNA. Okay. So X-ray diffraction will be studied by Rosalind Franklin. That is option B is the correct answer for 95th question. So now move on to the next question. Okay. So in oil immersion microscope observation, refractive index of the oil must be same as that of cover slip. Okay. Option C is the correct answer for 96th question. So now move on to the next thing. So from 97 to 100 paragraph, right? So we have to read this paragraph, then only we find out the answer. So in the 97th question, what they will ask? Cell signaling studied by the following methods except what? So while reading the paragraph, I get to know the answer for this question is option B. Okay, so in the paragraph, they will mention in vitro and vivo studies, and also this thing also mentioned, this is also mentioned. But here, option B, they will not mention about by taking out organs and studying them. That's why option B is the answer for 97th question. Okay, so now move on to the next question, that is 98. So cell communicate about the following except what? Okay, so here the answer for this question is option 98, right? Option D. Threads in the proximity is not mentioned in the paragraph. That's why option D is the correct answer. So now move on to the next question. It is 99, right? So here they will asking signals are transduced through receptors by the following mechanisms exception they will asking. So answer for this question is option C. Okay, in the paragraph they will mention about allow ion currents to flow, affect chromatin, and also this tension generated force, but they have not mentioned about this protein embedding process. That's why option C is the correct answer for 99 question. So now move on to the last question of this paper, that is okay. So breakthrough in the signaling field was made possible by the following except. Okay, so answer for this question is option A. So in the paragraph, they will mention about that the scientists realized that electronic circuits are analogous to signaling work. And also when scientists realized that both cell signaling and electronic circuits involved hierarchy, switches, modularity, redundancy, also they will mention in the paragraph. And also when scientists were able to apply computational biology to cellular signaling also, they will mention, but they will not mention about this this thing. That is, scientists were able to perform physical impossible experiments. It is not impossible. This is possible experiment. Okay, so that's why option A is the correct answer for this question. So this is about answer keys of life science question paper. So hope you people like this video. If you like this video, hit the like button and share maximum with your friends, and comment me if you got any something informations, and also how many marks you got, is your coming under the safest side and all, let me know in the comment box. Okay, so thank you so much for watching.